Right. So let's start with the next nakshatra, Punarvasu, quickly. And what we will be doing, we will be looking at the mantra of Punarvasu, the stories of Punarvasu, the result of different padas of Punarvasu, and the remedies of Punarvasu. And before we go there, Mridulaji have two questions. First of all, regarding the Yogdhara degrees of the nakshatras. Regarding the Yogdhara degrees of planet, the planet placed near the Yogdhara degrees of a nakshatra gives prominence and fame related to the signification of that planet. That is quite a prominent point that we should not miss in the analysis of the nakshatra. In this particular series, I haven't covered a few things, right? Activation, I haven't covered. This Yogdhara degrees, I haven't covered. Of course, all of them are covered in the Nakshatra course. That is a 4-part course. And this free series is just one part of it. Right. So the particular thing, the Yogdhara degrees, etc., are covered in the course, but haven't covered in this free series. And because we have already covered a few nakshatras, now it is very difficult to put it in the classes now. So what I will rather be doing, I will be making separate videos on them if time permits. But yes, that was taught in the course, right? The course have been very extensive, right? I will invite Vicky ji and Dipali ji, the two students, and Virendra ji to give a feedback about the course. They had the first part of the course. The second part is given as free. The third and the fourth part will be taught after this particular series. Please, bit feedback.
So Sarka Nakshatra course is, I should say, brilliant. It is very extensive. You cannot get so much information from anybody else, and that I can completely vouch for. Sir ko Dipali ji ne, I mean, sorry, abhi jo question pucha gaya animals ke baare mein. In the first part of the course, he has explained about animals in such a beautiful way where you can actually figure out how one's relationship will be with someone. So beautifully that it is simply marvelous. So sir ka course jo nakshatra ke related hai is fabulous, and at such a cost, I don't think so anybody teaches such a thing. It is very extensive and great, and I am grateful and blessed ke I am learning this from sir. So thank you so much.
Aap Dipali ji, main sabko pakdunga.
Yes sir, nakshatra course bahut badhiya hai aur wahan bahut sare जानने के लिए पर्सन जॉइनिंग नक्षत्रा कोर्स एंड आफ्टर जॉइनिंग योर नक्षत्रा कोर्स जस्ट बाय सीइंग द पर्सन आई एम एबल टू एनालाइज अ लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स रिलेटिंग टू दिस नक्षत्रास पदास एंड एवरीथिंग दैट इज वेरी सुपर कोर्स विच आई रिकमेंड एवरीवन टू जॉइन दिस कोर्स एंड गेट द बेनिफिट फ्रॉम दैट कोर्स बिकॉज ईच एंड एवरी पर्सन नीड टू नो अबाउट हिज नक्षत्रास एंड इट कैन हेल्प देम अ लॉट. And I'm very fortunate to join Subham course, Subham Sir's course. So I recommend it to everyone.
Virendra ji. Virendra ji, purane bachche.
Sir.
Ji.
क्या ही कहें सर, पहले तो शब्द ढूंढने पड़ेंगे. मतलब सर आपने सिखाया बहुत अच्छा, कसम से. मतलब और भी जगह पे कुछ मिला के सीखा, लेकिन आपने जो सिखाया, जो गहराई दी है सर, मतलब अगर समझने की बात अगर समझ में आ रहा है दिमाग में, तो मतलब यहाँ पे उतरा तो आप ही के द्वारा है. उसका तरीका भी है आपके पास सर. कुल मिला के आने पे ही आधा तो हल हो जा रहा है, बाकी आप सिखा रहे हैं सर, तो वो तो मान ही लीजिए कि अभी सर आपने सिखाया एक षष्ठी संहार और क्या कहते हैं, ये पहले भी आपने सिखाया था. आप एक सर आपने कंसल्टेशन किया था गरिमा का, याद होगा आपको. उसका सर तुला नक्षत्र, वो तुला लगन था. तो स्वाति नक्षत्र उसका फंस रहा था लगन में. और सेम सर उसकी अगर जिंदगी का पैटर्न देख लीजिए जो आप पढ़ा रहे हैं, मतलब उससे कहीं बाहर जा ही नहीं पा रहा है. मतलब उसका रोना, क्योंकि पहले ही हम लोग बात किए कि रोई देती है हर बात पे, तो वो मतलब अच्छा सर उस दिन भी ये क्लियर नहीं हुआ था, लेकिन अभी जो आपने जरा सी बात बोली है उसी से सारा ही क्लियर हो गया. अब तो लग रहा है सर कि अगर आदमी का कुछ देखना है तो इस पे फोकस कर लो, मतलब 80% तो मिल जाएगा सर. बहुत गजब है. और आपका तो सर क्या ही कहना है, मतलब बस विश्वास रख के आप पे अगर कोई चल ले तो फिर तो मान लीजिए कि शायद उसको सही जगह मिल जाएगी।
ट्रस्ट विश्वास इज डिफिकल्ट इन कलयुग।
हाँ बस बस
बट ट्रस्ट इज नीडेड, ट्रस्ट इज नीडेड,
ये जरूरी है सर। अगर भाव आदमी वैसा बना लेगा तो उसको मंजिल मिल जाएगी सर, मेरा ही मानना है। मतलब इतना ये सीखा आप ही से है सर। खैर
धन्यवाद। दिस पर्टिकुलर थिंग इज देयर, यू नो व्हाई आई ऑलवेज से दैट यू शुड लर्न एस्ट्रोलॉजी, बिकॉज़ इन अ कंसल्टेशन ऑफ 1 आवर और 2 आवर इट इज नॉट feasible to explain, you know, result of planet in all the 12 houses, all the 12 rashis, you know, like taking 9 planet in 12 house, 9 planet in 12 rashi, 9 planet in nakshatra, that is not very feasible to explain in a particular consultation, and that will take 4-5 hours or 4-5 ghanta ke aaram karte samay. That particular case, you know, it is essential to learn. That is Swati mein I will tell you one particular thing, na? Swati indicates the seashell and the pearl inside the seashell. So, you know, it a raindrop falls from the sky containing dust, and that falls into the seashell and it creates the pearl. So generally what happens, such people are, you know, like very much happy in their own domain, very much happy in their own life, and they are very precious, both emotionally, mentally and physically, very precious and very delicate like a pearl. But you know, that dirty drop of water comes from outside. So one external area of life which they cannot control, be it marriage, child, right, parents, one particular area of life that they cannot control, because you know, your success in profession you can control, that you can make excellence. Your health you can control, you can have good habits, but your parents you cannot control. Whether you will have a child or not, you cannot control. How your spouse will behave, you cannot control. So something that you cannot control comes from outside for Swati, and it creates the distortion in the self. It creates the distortion in their personal life. And because of that, because of, you know, that one particular thing that they cannot control becomes the reason of their crime. So that is there with Swati. Continuing with Punarvasu.
Sir, just to add, and for everybody, sir ke first part mein he's taught at least 15 to 16 significations of each nakshatra. I mean, just think about it, how extensive that course is. Wo ek part hi ek pura course ban sakta hai, but sir has been very generous in how much he's taught and how much he's still planning to teach. And nobody else can teach like him. So once again, thank you, sir.
Sir, aur
ek
baat hai ki aisa gyan kahin bhi nahi milega. Aap jaise guru mil jaye, to sab secret knowledge hum jaise logon ko aa jayegi. Wo baat to bahut
बढ़िया है। Like thank you for feedback. I am very overwhelmed. Or like just to give a glimpse of the course is technically 4 parts. And let me tell you, the price. The price is the point. The course is right now pointed at some 20,000 rupees for now. See, I cannot guarantee if I will increase the price in future. Let me be very honest with you, right? I can't guarantee you, but in that 20,000, you know, the course is 4 parts. The first part, we looked at significations. The second part is what we are going right now, right? That is the stories of the nakshatras. And the third part is there. In that third part, we will go to the classical result of nakshatras, right? Like why it is told that, you know, people born in Bharani will have this particular result. Why it is told that, you know, a lady born in Kritika should not be trusted. A lady born in Kritika will be, you know, backbiting with neighborhood people. Kritika mein paida hogi to padosan ke saath badke chugli karegi. So what is the result? Why this particular thing is happening? And you know, this is not a result, right? You know, she will talk with her neighbor in her neighborhood is not the real thing. Getting my point? The real thing is that person born in Kritika can be a leader in the society. Person born in Kritika can be elected as a member, elected as a panchayat member, elected as a MLA. That is the particular result of Kritika. That is not written. It is just told in the hints that she will be talking with the neighborhood lady. That may or may not be true. So when we go to the third part of the course, it is, you know, we will explain this particular significations, why it is told in classics that Ashlesha is a gandant, and that is told very bad. At the same time, Ashwini is also a gandant, but no bad results are given for Ashwini, whereas very bad results are given for Ashlesha. What is the problem? Like if you are born in the Ashlesha fourth pada, your father will die. or you will not have good relationship with father, but why? And you know what? Not even Ashlesha. Let me tell you, it is even told for Pushya that if you are born in the second pada of Pushya, then the father of your spouse will have a bad health, will die. So not only Gandhara nakshatras, other nakshatras are also bad. Why? What is that particular reason? What is that particular tendency? What is that particular curse attached to it? That we are going to see in the third part. And the fourth part, you know, although in the fourth part, I wanted to cover the Karma Vipak Samhita and the things given in Karma Vipak Samhita, right? But now my mind is a bit changing, right? And I don't want to cover the Karma Vipak Samhita. So when we will be going by the fourth part, we will be learning, you know, like how this nakshatras work when we go to transits and different chakras, right? Narakar chakras, when we go to Sarvato Bhadra chakra, how this nakshatras tend to work. When we go to Kalanal chakra, how these nakshatras work. This is what I want to add in the fourth part. And all these four part is taught in the same course, that is like 20,000 rupees. So you learn 27 nakshatras four times, right? And every class is almost 1.5 hour, 2 hour, right? So getting a it's quite an extensive course. And the amount is, I don't think it is a price that I'm costing for the knowledge.
For what you're teaching, sir, it is peanuts. I can say that for what you're giving, it is peanuts. And it is only, I think, somebody who really wants to learn the crux of nakshatras, you should come to Shubham, sir. There's no other person that you should go to. Sir, zindagi mein kabhi kisi ke liye kaha nahi, I've never come on social media, never come and said anything about any person that I've learned from. But when it comes to you, I don't know. It comes from the heart. So I'm very grateful once again, sir. But yes, everybody should do sir's nakshatra course.
यही तो राज की बात है. मैंने 16 साल के बच्चों को नहीं बोल रखा कि जा सोशल मीडिया पे मेरे बारे में लिख ना. मैंने अपने से उम्र में बड़े लोगों को अपना फैन बनाया. दिस अ पर्टिकुलर रीजन, समझ रहे आप बात को. मेरे पास टीम नहीं है बच्चों की. मैंने कोई 12वीं पास बच्चे नहीं पकड़े जा सोशल मीडिया पे लिख मेरे बारे में कितना अच्छा मैं कोर्स. 17 साल 20 साल के बच्चे नहीं है मेरे पास. राइट, देयर आर पीपल हु रियली कैन डू द थिंग. एंड यू नो आई डोंट बिलीव इन दिस पर्टिकुलर थिंग. आई नेवर टोल्ड एनीवन शेयर माय पोस्ट और राइट अ कमेंट फॉर मी और डू एनीथिंग. लाइक इट कम्स फ्रॉम योर हार्ट, दैट इज ऑल ओके. सी आई डू सो मेनी कंसल्टेशंस, आई टीच सो मेनी स्टूडेंट्स, यू विल नेवर सी एनीवन टॉकिंग फॉर मी बिकॉज आई नेवर टोल्ड एनीवन टू गो एंड डू दिस थिंग फॉर मी और टेक माय नेम और डू एनीथिंग. राइट, सो दैट इज अ पर्टिकुलर थिंग. कमिंग टू मृदुलाजी'स क्वेश्चन, द योगतारा डिग्रीज ऑफ द प्लैनेट आई विल ट्राई कवरिंग. The second question, Mridulaji, the Nakshatra animals, there is a free class on YouTube on Nakshatra animals. Nakshatra Union, Nakshatra animals, there is a free class on YouTube, right? And I don't know if I will remember to put it in the description, right? But still, I will be putting the link to that video in the description. If I forget to put the link in the description, just give a comment to the video and I will put the link in the description. Or you can search Nakshatra animal by Shubham Alok in YouTube and you will find that particular video that I have explained. A free video of the Maithunam course is there.
First part of course, mein, there's a complete one class full dedicated to this itself. So that also is very extensive.
And the animal is quite, animal is very, very important. The animal is like, because you know, man is a social animal, that is okay. But the man will have tendency of one particular animal. Like if I go to this Punarvasu, right, the nakshatra that we are dealing right now, if I go to Punarvasu Nakshatra, that indicates a cat. You know what cat have, like, talking of cat, Punarvasu Nakshatra is indicated by a cat. Leaving aside everything that I have taught, let me tell you three things about the cat. First of all, the child of the cat never sits. Sorry, never is not jumping like a monkey. The child of the cat, if cat leaves her child at a particular place, and you know, the child wants something, the child of the cat will not go at any place, will not follow her mother. Like the child of the cat will be sitting there crying for her mother, but will not move. This particular tendency is with Punarvasu. When they are in a problem, they don't look for their improvement. Rather, they look for remedies. 80% of the time, Punarvasu people tend to fail to see the problem in themselves. They think that the problem is with the situation. They are very much prone to taking remedies. And 80% of the time, Punarvasu people are laden with so many remedies that the biggest problem, the biggest problems that come in their life is because of not completing the remedies that they have taken that they will complete. Right. That is the prime reason that comes from the cat. Second thing, you know, that comes from the cat is, you know, the cat is supposed to, like, we people think that cat is having 9 lives. That 9 lives is an indicative of, you know, the person getting saved multiple times. So the person born in Punarvasu Nakshatra is highly intuitive. That he gets intuition very strongly. Anything that is going to happen with that particular person, they will know in advance. They will know in advance that this thing is going to happen. They will have foresight. First thing. Secondly, you know, multiple times they will be saved. Like, you know, I have seen Purarasu people, someone's wife. My client was consulting for his wife. He took a consultation. He was very happy. He consulted for his wife. And he told that my wife is having breast cancer. Purarasu, right? She was having 6th lord in Purarasu, lady. I told that, get it operated. She will be fine. 3rd stage cancer. He got it operated. The wife is all fine. Cancer operation happened in 2015. She's still okay, well living, right? So it is 9 lives, right? Even in the worst situation, even in cancer-like situation, the person is saved. 9 lives, no? So the death doesn't come very easily. The second trait for cat. Coming to the 3rd trait of cat, you know, regarding the cat, like I will give you a good advice. After that, we will come to prediction. Cat always lives in dark places, right? You can see a dog very freely. You will not be able to see a cat very freely. The problem with Punarvasu is when they discuss something, you know, when they disclose something on social media, when they let people know about things, they are very prone to getting the bad effect of evil eye. When they tell their things to other people, the thing actually start perishing. They should not be telling anything on social media, etc. They should be keeping everything secret. If Punarvasu person wants to do something, do it secret, do it hidden. Don't tell it to anyone because they are very prone to getting the result of, you know, evil eye, and the thing will not get completed. And that is one of the things. Okay. Regarding prediction, regarding this particular thing of Punarvasu, you know, the Punarvasu is also having, always having a dark side, right? The cat lives in darkness, right? No one knows about the cat. So Punarvasu person is always having a dark side, right? Punarvasu person is like, you know, like a social influencer. Having a strong Punarvasu will have, you know, like they will have something like, you know, like money laundering or, you know, got some negativity spread about themselves just to get fame. That kind of scenario have to be there. If that kind of scenario is not there, then, you know, a very dark background story. Like suppose someone is a very good farmer. I will tell you, one of my clients is a very good farmer, right? Like in Karnataka, he's one of the top farmers. Right? He have a flower plantation in some 200 acres. And one of the very prominent people, one of the very prominent farmers in Karnataka, he have even been interviewed by many channels on how he have implemented the technology, etc. And you know, he have 10th lord in Punarvasu. What happened, this person like started giving tuitions, etc. from 8th, 9th standard. He worked very hard, saved money. He wanted to become a scientist. But his family people never supported him to become a scientist. His family members were farmers and they wanted him to become a farmer. Right. So he implemented all his knowledge in farming. He had been interviewed by many channels, etc. also. You know, so there's a backstory. That he saved money, he worked so hard to, you know, become a scientist. But because of the peer pressure, because of the family pressure, he was not able to become a scientist. He became a farmer. Rajyoga was there in the horoscope. He became a very good farmer, earns good money, everything, you know. But that desire of becoming a scientist is still there in his life, right? Right now, the person is in his 50s. He has 2 children, wife, like both female. But he still wants to become a scientist. So that dark part of the story. Crushing of talents, pushing of talents is something that is related to cat, you know, living in dark. People don't know. And, you know, it is always, you know, the Punarvasu is very much like, you know, just surfaced on the top. About the Punarvasu person, you don't know about the background. That Punarvasu person is quite secretive. You don't know from where it came. It just happened. Right? So if the 7th lord is in Punarvasu, you know that she have a very beautiful wife and you know everything about the person. But if he is having 7th lord in Punarvasu, you don't know things about his wife, her background, like from where she belonged, her habits, and thinks about her spouse, he will not know because he's having seventh lord in Kurus, right? He himself will not know multiple things about the spouse, right? So Punarvasu is very much related to hidden things. If I have my seventh lord in Punarvasu, my wife will not put everything very clearly in front of me. Getting my point? Multiple things will be hidden. And things will keep on coming time by time. You know, Punarvasu indicates a break of relationship because of relivation. Cat, right? Cat. Cat lives in darkness. So generally what happens, you know, you marry, if you have seventh lord in Punarvasu, you married someone. And you're like, okay, she's a good lady, I got married. 1 year after marriage, you get to know that before marriage, she had been in relationship. And okay. Then 2 years after marriage, you come to know that from that relationship, like that was a very long relationship. That guy also came to her family and fought with her brother, etc. also. Then 3 years after marriage, you will come to know that she also had a child with that person and she got aborted. Then 5 years after marriage, you will come to know that that guy is still behind her. It is the relevation coming with time by time, making the relationship weaker, 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 weaker. That particular thing happens with Punarvasu. Right. Coming to the particular name. The name of Punarvasu is very important. You know, the name of Punarvasu is very important. Punarvasu. The names are very important. Of course, covered it in the course. Punarvasu means what? Re-establishing. Punar, once again, Vasu. Keep on living. Punarvasu, suppose there is a destroyed city. If that city is repopulated, that is Punarvasu. Punarvasu, life gets a very good start. Life goes very good. One tornado will come and everything will be destroyed. And after that, things will start happening again. Punarvasu person, very beautiful in school. Very attracted, everyone loved them. Good in academics, like popular in family. Mother loves them a lot, father loves them a lot, right? Gets in relationship with someone, did love marriage. After doing that love marriage, the husband started exploiting, blackmailing. But he had the habit of keeping it secret, right? He kept everything hidden, being exploited by the wife, being exploited by the spouse. He kept everything hidden. But one day someone finds out that this problem is happening. Now pressure have to come there, right? As I told you, pressure will come. So their family member will pressure them to get out of the relationship. They get out of the relationship. The thing is completely devastated. The person is broken. He have the person rebelled from his family to get married to this particular person because that was a love marriage, right? And because of love marriage and the abuse in marriage, there are scars on the mind, scars on the emotions, right? The person is not able to trust. Because, you know, cat is a very afraid animal, right? Cat is a very, very fearful animal. Cat is a very timid animal. Cat is not very strong. Cat will not start attacking like a dog will do. Right? So, you know, like she has scars all over her mind and emotions. She's not able to trust on people, etc. And she will remain in this condition for long. The person, like she or he, whatever it may be, will remain in that condition for long. For 2 years, 3 years, not able to trust people, not talking to anyone, going completely inward, like speaking very less. And after that, you know, solace of 4 and 5 years, someone will start loving that person. And now this person will be very reluctant to go into the relationship, very reluctant to start a new life. But that person will force them to start a new life, to come in relationship with them. And the relationship will start and then it will be good. So Punarvasu indicates a complete destruction. And after the complete destruction, a big trauma. And after that trauma, it indicates very good result. That is the thing related to Punarvasu. And you know what? There is one more thing. Have you seen an image where a person don't want to go forward and there are 2-3 people pushing him from behind? That is what Punarvasu is. Punarvasu indicates a gate. There is a great transformation in life that is present from day one. There is a comfort zone. And there is a way out of the comfort zone. There is a way out of that comfort zone. there is a revolution, there is a jump, there is a gate to success, a gate to fame, a gate to liberation. That gate will be present in front of this person for a lifetime. But he or she will not be able to take that step. Take that courageous step, she will not be able to. She will have to be pushed. The person have to be pushed. The person have to be under high level of pressure to cross that particular gate. You know, recently you saw a video of a Muslim lady jumping in a river in the Gujarat, Ahmedabad, I think, or some other place in Gujarat, right? So you know, there is a bad marriage, but parents are pressurizing you to remain in the marriage because of social traditions and customs. The lady have all the chance. The lady have friends who is I'm now just making up the story, right? It is whether true with that lady or not, I don't know, right? But there is a chance to take a divorce and break free. It is India, of course, right? There's a chance to get associated with NGO and break your way out. There's a door open, but you don't pass through that door. If a malefic is in a prarosa, if a benefic is in a prarosa, you take that door and you take the liberation. A lady being exploited and being beaten in her family, in her husband's home every day, takes the step out, goes to a different city for study. He studies there, gets into profession, earns money, gets power, divorces her husband, and live a free life, right? So Punarvasu is a gate. Punarvasu is a gate of transformation. But before passing that gate of transformation, there's a big tornado and everything is lost. Fifth Lord in Punarvasu, lady conceives, lost her child. Two children lost on the same day, right? One child was some 5 years and second child was some 7-8 years. One day, one accident, both the child and husband died. Right. After some time, the lady marries again, gets married again. The torment and everything is there, the sadness is there. Once again, she conceives and now she have a child. And now her child is he will be 27, 28, right? Studying somewhere in Vancouver, etc. I don't remember the place exactly now. Getting my point? That is what comes with Punarvasu. The gate of transformation and the lack of courage to go through it. A big tornado, a big devastation and resettlement. And the coming of hope. Got my point? Coming to the mantra, the first word in the mantra is Aditya Punarvasu Vataha Parastha Dramavastata. Aditya Punarvasu. See, this is the first nakshatra where the word Aditya comes. And you know what Aditya have? Let me tell you 2-3 stories about Aditya. Aditya have 12 forms, right? So this person, this Punarvasu person is entirely different in different areas, right? This Punarvasu can be a lady who is very shy in her appearance, but very open in the other pleasures of mental life, right? It can be a person who is very silent from outside, but very angry from inside, right? She have different aspects of her personality. I don't know why when I'm talking of Punarvasu, I'm taking female example, right? But with whichever gender I take, whether I take a female example or a male example, it's applicable to both, right? So a Punarvasu lady or a Punarvasu man will have, you know, different examples. It will have different shades of life. One is completely black, one is completely white. That is what is indicated by Aditya, point one. Point two, the problem from siblings and the problem from family members is very evident. For a Punarvasu, the problem doesn't come from outside. The problem is always from inside, right? The problem is from their own children. The problem is from their own family member. And especially the problem is from their own siblings. siblings, brother and sisters are the main problem creators. If not evidently, then unintentionally, unconsciously. But siblings are one of the biggest obstacles in life. Right? That's about the Aditya. And one more particular thing is, you know, this Punarvasu people should have a habit of, should develop a habit of ignoring things. Right? Like Aditya, they have to be constantly on move. They should constantly be forgetting the previous memory and making new memories. They should constantly be forgetting past experiences and creating new experiences if their life is on a standstill. If their life stops, if they themselves stop their mental or emotional growth, in that scenario, the life will be very difficult, the experiences will be very difficult, and it will be very difficult for them to survive. Right? So the, you know, the subtle art of forgetting things and moving on in life is very essential for them. Otherwise, it will struck. Right? Which in another way also indicates, as I have been telling you from starting, it indicates a very strong upturn of events. Right? Everything is happening, you know, very bad. The seventh lord is in Punarvasu. Like, you know, you, whichever person you loved, you know, cheated you. But you have to constantly keep on forgetting, keep on forgetting, keep on forgetting. And one thing is very prominent here. When Punarvasu person does anything, it is a disaster. But when the thing comes automatically to them, then it is a boon. Then it is a thing which leads them to happiness. Once again, you know, Punarvasu, the word Punarvasu itself indicates the restoration of good. So as I told you, once after devastation, good things will start happening. Going further, the shloka is Aditya Punarvasu Vata. Vata means wind. They are very strong in their physique. Diseases generally don't disturb them, and they are. Let me tell you one particular thing. If there is a nakshatra in the zodiac which is capable to do everything, that is Punarvasu. Once again, they are like Hanuman. They need to be realized of the things that they have done. See, Vayu have two children, Bhim and Hanuman. Both of them are very mighty and very powerful. It is someone who is strong physically, strong mentally, strong emotionally, strong intellectually, strong in every field, multifaceted. But they have to realize their potential. The biggest problem that lies with Punarvasu is that they are not realizing their own potential. And either they are very emotional Cancer part, or they are very logical Gemini part. But they are not realizing their potential. And most importantly, there is a problem with balance. Very low air is not good. Very high air is a tornado. A balanced air is something which lets you sleep in peace. Right? So balance, they have multiple talents, but either they are using all of their talents at once or no talents. Right? So a balance in the talents, using the right talent at the right time, is something that is needed, right? By the time we will finish the Ashlesha, I will be giving you one particular example, one chart. I will be taking one chart where I will explain the result of, you know, all the planets in a nakshatra, like all the planets in all nakshatras, right? So I will be taking one random chart and we'll be taking the nakshatra of every planet for that chart and we'll be predicting based on that chart. So like, and I will select it from the commenting people. People who have been commenting constantly from Ashwini up to Ashlesha. I will select like one person from the whole thing. Right. So that I will be doing just to illustrate you how the explanation or how the, you know, how the prediction is done or how the analysis is done. Right. So be careful about that. Make a comment, because if you don't make a comment, how do I know that you are watching the video? That I don't see the people who watch the video. Right. We can see that particular thing, right? So that is there with wind, right? Wind is very mighty and very powerful, but they have to realize their potential. One particular thing is there, enmity with children, either loss of child or enmity with child is very prominent. Bhim had a son, Ghatotkach was, right? Ghatotkach haven't had a good fate in the Mahabharata war, right? Hanuman had a child who was serving as a, like, you know, as a guard to the palace of Ahiravan, when Rama and Lakshmana was took in hell, right, and he had to fight his own father. So generally, you know, fighting with their own children, getting opposed by their own children is a trend with Punarvasu. And specifically, you know, bad relationship with their children. And as I told you, bad relationships with children and siblings and parents, all of them, is a trend of Punarvasu. Right? Punarvasu is also moist. Right? So all the things related to moist that I have told you related to Agra is also applicable here. Right? Like in houses, the houses in 2 and 12 have some impact. The same is the story with nakshatras also. And houses, nakshatras previous to the nakshatra and nakshatra next to the nakshatra have some impact on the nakshatra. Understand that the zodiac is a complete circle, right? And in circle, every point influences another point because circle indicates infinity, right? So that moist part is there. So from Agra, I will take up three particular things. Moist, they are very emotional, but at a particular point of time, all their emotions will dry up. All their emotions will be lost. And so, you know, there can be a case when a Punarvasu is loving you so much. And one day you wake up, they wake up, and you feel no love or no connect towards each other. No love, no connection towards your profession if you have 10th lord in a Punarvasu. Right? That thing can surely happen, point one. You know, point two, the Punarvasu person is very emotional, very much given to doing good with people, very much caring, very much sophisticated, but over the time, going to the bad experiences, all of his experiences will turn sore, all of their experiences will turn bad, and over the time, the goodness of Punarvasu, the beneficence of Punarvasu will evaporate, and then there have to come one experience for the reinstation of, or one experience which will put all the emotion back. But the theme of starting as a highly emotional person, all the emotions being dried up, then living the life in depression and despair, and then once again influx of all the emotions once again through a second person is the trait for Punarvasu. Got my point? Coming to the stories of Punarvasu. Punarvasu supports everything. Punarvasu supports everyone. Right? They are highly supportive to everyone. To their spouse, they will support in profession. To their mothers, they will support in their home duties, etc. Right? They are highly supportive to everyone, even to their children, even to their colleagues, even to their neighborhood people, they will be very much helpful. Right? And there is a very specific thing, you know, this Punarvasu person have to work 24/7. They generally have a dual life. They are, you know, very much active in professional life as well as they have to be a homemaker, right? Their responsibilities, their duties, their work never end in 24 hours of a day. Punarvasu is really the person who needs the 25th hour in the day that they will never come, that they will never get, right? And you know what? This Punarvasu is very pure at heart, very clear at heart. And if there is one thing that pisses off the Punarvasu is, you know, getting in contact with someone who is clever, getting in contact with someone who, you know, like, he is very clear at heart. Punarvasu is not known to someone who is, you know, jo chalak hai. Punarvasu is not known to someone who is clever. Punarvasu is not known to someone who is shrewd. So, you know, people being clever, people being shrewd, people looking for their own benefit is something which disheartens Punarvasu, right? Punarvasu don't know the clever ways, etc. Right? So, such people Punarvasu will hate very strongly. And so, if the 10th Lord is in Punarvasu, you are supposed to meet cheats in your profession, right? And you hate cheating in your profession. If the 4th Lord is in a Punarvasu, then you got cheated by a property dealer or you got cheated in some vehicle-related scenario. If the 2nd Lord is in a Punarvasu, then you got cheated in a bank or some bank-related fraud is evident, right? So, like, analyze it in this particular way. Coming to So once again, I have covered almost every story, etc. related to Punarvasu. Now I have to take the result of different padas of Punarvasu. But before we go that, three remedies. Right? Three remedies for Punarvasu. Right. So I will be giving you three particular remedies for Punarvasu. Okay. Plant trees. Important. Punarvasu person, make sure to plant trees. Right. Specifically, Punarvasu person should have Tulsi at their home. Right. If not Tulsi, if you're from another region, planting trees and taking care of them like your children is one of the most important thing. Point one. Point two, take care of at least one animal. Okay. Like have any animal, you can have a dog, a stray dog in your society, or you can have any animal like cow for Hindus, or a dog or any animal, and take care of that particular animal. Or take care of a tree like your child for a lifetime. That is remedy number one that I will say for Punarvasu. Remedy number two, you know, one of the most strong remedy that I can give you is, you know, if any temple is being made or any religious institution is being made, right? Contribute to the building of that institution. If a temple is being made, contribute bricks or contribute money for the building of it, or, you know, continue the or contribute the chhatra for the deity, you know, the flag for the temple. So contributing something to a religious temple or mosque or church that is being made, or a gurudwara that is being made, is one of the best remedies that can, that should be done. And the third thing that I will say for Punarvasu is, have at least one habitat in your home. What do I mean by habitat? Like, you know, fish aquarium, fish pond. That one type of habitat. Try maintaining a habitat in your home. An aquarium, pond, or, you know, like, or keeping water for birds, etc. Try having one such thing in your home. And that is something that I will recommend. Coming to the padas of Punarvasu. The first pada of Yes,
sir, ye jo fish aquarium hai, do we look at the sign Pisces also for this, or it doesn't matter? Ye bahut sara confused topic hai, been put by everybody. Okay, if you want to put keep a fish aquarium at home, your sign Pisces should be good.
Okay. Can be taken. Like, because fish is there in Pisces, we can say that if you have a good Pisces, you should have the aquarium, otherwise not. But if I want to have a pet dog, then which sign indicates dog? But if I want to have a pet parrot, then? So my thing is, if you have sixth house and sixth lord good, sixth house indicates pet animals. Sixth house, sixth lord good, you can have, otherwise don't have. Pisces, yeah, can be taken as a logic here. Yeah. Seems convincing. Punarvasu pada one. The person is very much inclined to do their duties, but will fail in doing their duties, specifically related to their siblings and their children. There is a strong sense of that I haven't completed my duty related to children's. Skin and speech related problems are evident. Generally, the health is not good. Nervous problems and breathing problems are there, right? Health problems are there, but the longevity is good. Longevity is okay. The person tries to earn money either working in banking sector or is in business or in writing. Right. The person tries to earn money, the person tries to save money, and after the age of 28, he will be able to do it. Before the age of 28, it is a bit difficult to save money or make something. The relationship with sibling and the relationship with children is not very good. right? The relationship with parents also is not very good. Generally, they are cheated in relationship. Should not be in a love relationship. Cheating in relationship is very evident. Specifically, cheating related to finances in relationship is strongly seen. Right? Along with this, the person is good in studies and writing. Specifically, they can make a change through their writing. They should try to become a leader. There is no one who will listen to them, or there is no one who will understand for them. They have to take their own flag. And, you know, they have to be protector for their own rights, and they should make sure that nothing wrong happens to them. They have to, like, you know, make a voice for themselves. Right? Good in business. It is a sign which is very good in business. Related to luck, when they are very much determined that good happens to them, then good will happen. The Punarvasu first pada have a problem that they will be expecting bad results only. So the biggest problem with Punarvasu first pada is whenever they are confronted to something, they start having a negative approach. If they are doing this particular thing, if they are having a negative approach toward things, in that scenario, only bad will happen to them. If they are having a positive approach, then positive things will happen with them. The approach, the mentality, the thinking of Punarvasu first pada attracts the fate for them. So they have to be a bit careful about it. Right? They will not be very fair in complexion. They will be a bit dark in their complexion. Right? Their eyes will be big. The chest will be broad. The upper part of the body will be prominent. They will be skillful in teaching. They will be skillful in drawing, dancing, painting, skillful in one of the arts, right? And they will be like funny, joking in disposition, and they will not take anything on their heart, right? They will be like very quite easy going in life, right? That is for the first pada of Punarvasu. The second pada of Punarvasu is very good to gain money. They should be related to either arts, dancing, singing, painting, music, etc., or should be related to things of fashion and things related to women's interest, fashion, perfumes, clothes, etc. Right? They are the one who will like strengthen the voice for people, highly determined, and sometimes you can also say them as a real adamant. Right? Along with this, it is very good for finances and specifically related to happiness of family. Right? And they have a very, their family supports them, and even the family of the husband supports them, right? But the relationship with the spouse is not very good. The spouse is supposed to be a bit adamant, right? And whatever thing they have made in their life, or whatever things they are gifted with, and whatever things their parents give them or their spouse gives them, they will tend to lose, or they will tend to lose that particular thing. There is a long period in life which they spend in isolation or living alone or on self-contemplating. Meditation is highly recommended, right? They will have generally female siblings and female children only. They have a very good home, and their home will have very positive vibrations. They will have a very good, a very big home, right? The happiness from home is there. They are generally lucky, right? They will live a disease-free life and will not have much opposition, but even doesn't matter they are male or female, they should be very sure not to hurt a female. If they ever hurt a female in life, then bad luck will follow. For the second pada of Punarvasu, the second pada of Punarvasu person will be a bit dark in complexion, but he will be worth praising. Like, you know, people will fantasize about him. People will want to become like him. He will be intelligent, soft-spoken, delicate, warm in heart, welcoming everyone, right? Very good speech, will be a bit tall, right? Hands and legs will be exceptionally tall, as the person will look like someone from a different world, right? They will have very expressive eyes, big, and their eyes will always be looking at one place or the other place, and will be very good in arts. Specifically, will be very good in fine arts, and will be interested in at least one of the arts, dancing, singing, any one of that, they will be very much interested in. Right, coming to the third pada of Punarvasu. The third pada of Punarvasu is very good. Right. The third pada of Punarvasu is very good. The person is great. Right? A very good person. Worth following. A person with a great following. Very good in mathematics, very good in speech. Very good in mathematics, very good in speaking, very good in speech, very good in business, very good in talking. Can very efficiently convey what he wants to say. Right? He is very, very well versed in judgment. Right, emotional, fickle, right? They find it very difficult to do something for long. Punarvasu, third pada, their habit of losing interest in things is something that will trouble them a lot. Along with this, there will be problem. They can be either only child or either only one brother. Or only female siblings. In having children, they will have some difficulty. And children general can come through unconventional ways of IVF, etc. also. Right. And specifically, they are very joking in this position, happy-go-lucky kind of a person. Right. Will be very lucky, will be adherent devotee of Vishnu, or will be very faithful in their religion. The prominence in profession is very evident. Many people will follow them. Many people will want to become like them. So if Venus is there, many people want to become like them in relationship. People consider them an expert on relationship. If Mars is there, then people consider them very good in handling the people. Right? So depending on the planet, you should take it. Okay. And so that's all. The person will have like round eyes, which will be dark, round, dark, deep eyes, deep voice also. The body will be very attractive. They will have a very great sex appeal. The person of people of another gender will be very much attracted to them. They will be highly successful. They will be very intelligent. And they will be very sexually oriented. They will have a very strong sexual life and they will be sexually oriented. And sexuality is quite prominent. And they will be good in poetry, they will be good in worldly knowledge, they will be good in debating, they will be good in putting up their points. They will be good in these particular things, right? Coming to the fourth pada of Punarvasu, emotion. Emotion and problem related to emotion is the first pada of Punarvasu. They are fickle, disturbed, always thinking on different topics, never able to come at a single conclusion, very attractive, very popular, people of other gender always flock them, have a very good marital life, very devoted wife, beautiful wife, generally goes for a love marriage. They will be blamed for something that they have never committed. Despite being popular and successful, they will have many people talking bad about them. They will have many false allegations and many false obligations, but people will want to follow them in their profession. People will want to become like them. They will be quite prominent, right? They will be respected, awarded, acclaimed. Will generally have sisters and female children only. Male children is quite difficult. Actually, in the starting part of the zodiac, the male children is very less. Only female children are indicated. Because Lakshmi starts the creation, of course, at the end of the day. And this much. They will have good relationship with family. With own family, they will have a good relationship. With the spouse's family, they may not have a good relationship. Right? They are prominent in life. People want to follow them. I have already told this particular point. They have good comfort from a vehicle and their mother supports them. They have a very strong influence of their mother over them. Right? They have good property. Their property is also favorable to them. They can work in import-export. They can work related to properties, and they can be good doctors, they can be good healers, nurse. Regarding the profession of the nakshatras, I will be doing a special class in the course on which professions are indicated by nakshatras, right? So course people will get it, the list of nakshatras per profession, right? And generally it indicates living in foreign lands. It is someone who is always on move. There is no stability in the life. Punarvasu, fourth pada. there's no stability in life. There are a whole lot of travels. And specifically, these people are will find it very difficult to come at a conclusion, will find it very difficult to take a pledge of something and follow it. Fluctuation in life, fluctuation in their residence, fluctuation in their thoughts is a theme. The person will be extremely clean, devoted, and given to like cleaning everything, like a cleaning freak, right? Charming, beautiful, fair colored, like extremely white, attractive, with a very beautiful hair. Curly hair can also be there, like, but their stomach will be broad, right? And will be given to eating much, right? Like eating much as expected by their body weight BMI ratio, right? Their face will be very impressive, can be interested in dancing or music. Their eyes will be big and broad. They will generally be thin, but will eat much, right? And their shoulders will be broad. And they will be like the Punarvasu fourth pada, they will unnecessarily be laden with multiple responsibilities. Right? And that's all for Punarvasu, right? Thank you for watching the video. If you liked it, and comment. Right? Thank you for watching. Namaskar.
Thank you, sir.
Namaskar. There was a particular question by Pratulji that some people say that Adra indicates bad mental life, and if there is any planet in seventh to Adra, that is like seventh to Gemini in Sagittarius, then it gives bad mental life. According to me, I will answer it in four ways. Point one, regarding nakshatras, if you look at it, one particular thing is indicated by many nakshatras, right? Like for an example, being emotional. Emotion is indicated by multiple nakshatras. Emotion was indicated by Adra. Emotion is indicated by Punarvasu. Emotion will be indicated by many other nakshatras also, right? So generally, so coming to marriage also, there will be multiple nakshatras which indicates bad marriage, right? So generally, bad marriage will only come when one of these nakshatras are afflicted. And using this approach of like, you know, when planet is placed seventh to this particular nakshatra, bad marriage will happen is something that I think is not good. Secondly, like there are houses in the horoscope, no? First house in the horoscope, second house in the horoscope. There are different positions for the nakshatra also. For an example, there is a karma nakshatra, there is a jati nakshatra, there is a sanghar nakshatra, there is a vainasik nakshatra, there is a anujanam nakshatra, there is a trijanam nakshatras. And these nakshatras are different from the birth nakshatra, right? For an example, the 19th nakshatra from the prime nakshatra is known as Adhan nakshatra, right? So Adhan means conception. So suppose you have Mars in suppose you have Mars in Ashwini. 19th nakshatra from that Ashwini will be some nakshatra, right? And that is known as Adhan nakshatra, that is conception nakshatra. So suppose 19th nakshatra from Ashwini is having Mercury. Then what type of result Mars is supposed to give in Ashwini is very much influenced by that Mercury, right? So in that scenario, Mars in Ashwini, Ashwini indicates horse, fast. Mars indicates powerful, aggressive. And Mercury decides the result, right? So this person is very fastly and very aggressively growing his business. Mercury business, like setting the trend. So for house, for nakshatras also, there are different nakshatras from a nakshatra which play a vital role. So in the case of analysis, that should be given more importance. Like you have houses in horoscope, there can be houses in the nakshatra chart as well. Right? Second point. The third point is, as we are going to cover in the course, there are different chakras for nakshatras also. Right? And there is a Narakar chakra for everything. So suppose you are judging the result of a planet, take seventh lord, and seventh lord is Saturn. So that Saturn is, you can make a Narakar chakra for Saturn. Narakar is human shaped chakra for Saturn, because Saturn is the seventh lord. And then there are a few bad nakshatras from that particular nakshatra. Like the nakshatras that will fall in the hand will be bad. So from that Saturn, who is the seventh lord, if there are planet in badly placed nakshatras, then it will create problem in marriage. That is the third way of analysis. And the fourth thing, you know, is what I always say. If there is no combination for bad marriage as per the nakshatra, then believe that there is no problem in the horoscope of this person, and the problem happened with the muhurta of the marriage, or problem happened with the matchmaking, right? Because if we have the approach of always finding the problem in the birth chart only, then we will miss the wider perspective of what happened bad with muhurta or what happened bad with the matchmaking, right? So mean make nikalna, chidran veshan karna, jo hai, that should not be appreciated. You know, finding all the faults in the birth horoscope only should not be appreciated. If there is no planet in a particular nakshatra, if the seventh lord is not indicating a bad marriage, then don't go to, like, you know, see, this is what I say. Use the classical rules and try to find out why it happened. But if you cannot find a classical rule, don't try to introduce new rules to find out why it happened bad. Rather, widen your perspective and see other aspects of matchmaking, etc., to see why it went bad, right? Because unnecessarily expanding the particular thing, making 200 rules to analyze marriage, in the end, will lead you to a confused state when you want to analyze marital life for a person.